Hey, this is Ryan of Happy Healthy Vegan. Let me know if you saw this study as well. It was not that widely reported by the mainstream media, but enough. It was originally published in the Journal of Animal Frontiers, and the title of the study, Protein and Muscle Health During Aging, Benefits and Concerns Related to Animal-Based Protein. And the study came to a few startling conclusions slash implications. The chief one here is saying that increasing the ratio of animal-based protein relative to plant-based protein in the diet may help to mitigate age-related losses of muscle mass and strength. So if you're thinking you heard something wrong here, you didn't. These researchers are recommending that people in general, and older people in particular, should up their intake of meat. Eat more meat is what they're saying, because animal protein is superior to plant protein as far as maintaining muscle mass and strength. This paper goes on to praise the virtues of beef for having all these great nutrients and categorizes beef as a nutrient-rich food. Well, at least these researchers acknowledge that what they're suggesting here, to eat more meat and eat fewer plants, get more protein from meat, is a little bit controversial, because a lot of people have heard maybe eating meat's not all that healthy. And as they say here, animal-based proteins may be associated with chronic diseases such as heart disease, colorectal cancer, breast cancers, prostate cancers, and they cite 3 or 4 studies down below to show that there may be some harmful effects about eating meat. And it's funny how they just, how do they pick these random 3 or 4 studies, because the preponderance of the scientific evidence shows that meat consumption is not healthy. For example, the World Health Organization, when they came out with their recommendations against eating red and processed meat a couple years ago, they analyzed over 800 studies to come to that conclusion. So anyway, let's get back to our main study. And of course, they're not going to acknowledge that they could have cited nearly 1,000 studies showing that eating animal products is unhealthy. They just picked 3 or 4 random ones. They want it to seem like there's equal amounts of evidence on both sides, because here's the other side. They say, however, additional studies published conflicting results, which further muddle our understanding on how animal-based proteins are related to human health needs. So they make it sound like we really don't know. Animal protein could be good, it could be bad, there's just conflicting information, we don't know. Again, the preponderance of the evidence says animal products are bad. But anyway, let's take a look at these studies that they pointed out here, that they referred to, that show that animal-based proteins are healthy. Let's look at the most recent one here and see what it says. So this study was a meta-analysis of animal fat or animal protein and their link, if any, to colorectal cancer. And the study concluded that the evidence does not support an independent association between animal fat or animal protein and colorectal cancer. However, if you go look at the sources of funding for this study, look, it has the meat industry all over it. So anyway, let's get back to our main study here. And I love how these researchers kind of waffle back and forth between, yeah, more meat, it's got all this great protein and nutrients, and but maybe not, because there might be some disease. They say here, for example, the high fat content in animal-based proteins has been linked to cancers and cardiovascular disease. But, because you know, there's a but coming here, but some of the fats found in lean meats and low-fat dairy have shown to be beneficial. And that's all they say, like, beneficial in what? Like, it prevents heart disease, it makes a cold go away, it's good for your toe if it's sore. And they linked to 2 studies here, so once again, let's follow the most recent one and see what it says. Unfortunately for the text of this paper, I couldn't search through the text. It's not an HTML file, so all I have is this PDF. So I visually tried to find any discussion of low-fat meats and some kind of benefits. I personally couldn't find one. Not to say it's not in there, it's just not something that's talked about much. Maybe it's something they mentioned aside. But what I definitely did find in the conclusion here, which doesn't bode well for our main paper, is they observed that red meat intake was associated with increased overall and breast cancer risk. And these findings suggest that limiting red meat intake may not only be beneficial for colorectal cancer, but also for the prevention of other tumor locations such as breast cancer. So anyway, let's get back to our main study here, the one that's telling people to up their intake of meat so they can get all that animal protein and stop eating all those Beyond Burgers and soy, stop eating that plant protein, because the animal protein is superior for muscle health and strength. How can they make this recommendation knowing, as they acknowledged, all the various health risks associated with animal proteins? Yes, they tried to minimize that risk as far as people's psychology goes by saying, oh, we don't really know, and they're not being truthful about how the preponderance of the evidence shows that animal products are unhealthy for you. how can they make this recommendation? Well, let's take a look at the authors of the study and try to figure out what's going on. Well, as always, look at the sources of funding. And once again, look, this study is funded by, guess who? The meat industry. No less than 3 sources of funding from the beef and cattle industry. So if you're wondering how in this day and age, a study can come out and recommend that people up their intake of meat while simultaneously decreasing their consumption of plant proteins, well, now you see how. This study is funded by the meat industry. And did you notice what happened here too? How they were referring to some studies that show that, we don't know, eating meat might not be all that unhealthful at all. And as I showed earlier, that study that they referred to was also funded by the meat industry. So you have a meat industry funded study referring to other meat industry funded study showing that eating meat isn't all that unhealthy. So this is what we're up against here in this misinformation war. Let me just paint you the picture of how it works. I call it the trickle-down theory. It's kind of what happens in the petroleum industry, it happened before in the tobacco industry. But basically, you have these well-funded meat industry companies, like the ones I showed you here, funding studies that support conclusions that they want. And once they get the conclusions that they want, they make news releases, press releases, so that major mainstream media outlets like, say, the Daily Mail, Telegraph, New York Post, and all will pick up on these showing, hey, look, it's not that bad to eat meat after all. We really don't know. For all we know, it's good for you. And then the next step is to get anti-vegans of all shapes and sizes, from like Joe Rogan down to the smaller carnivore vloggers, talking about, see, eating meat isn't bad for you at all. But it all goes back to industry-funded studies. And people like to accuse me and other vegans of cherry picking, and no, it's the opposite. I never cited an industry funded study to support my point of view. I mean, comment down below, is there a broccoli industry? Is there a potato cartel industry funding science? No, of course not. There's no such thing. But I find it completely ironic and disingenuous when you have these anti-vegans and even like just regular lay people, like your uncle who thinks you're weird because you're vegan. They'll cite these studies when they see them come out in the news, like, aha, I told you eating meat's not bad for you. And then you have to explain to them, like, well, that science is not as good as the science that backs up vegan diets, because all the studies that you're showing me here are funded by the meat and dairy industries. Well, the science I'm showing you here is not funded by any industry of that sort. So anyway, leave your questions and comments down below. What do you think about them going after plant-based protein here? It shows you what a sign of the times is that they're attacking not only just plants, but plant-based protein, because they're seeing a lot of competition here now. So anyway, comment on that, hit like, share this video, let people know what's really up, and until next time, guys, let's remember to vote vegan. Round.